California's Central Valley today is home to 7 million people, the state's capital city of Sacramento, and generally contains farmland almost as far as the eye can see. But it wasn't so long ago, geologically speaking, that this entire region was several hundred feet underwater. For a moment, imagine that you were to suddenly find yourself 700,000 years ago at the peak of the Sutter Buttes, which is the highest point in the Central Valley. While today, you can see the Sierra Nevada mountains to the east and the coast ranges to the west, you would unexpectedly see something completely different. This can't be right. This looks like Lake Michigan. As you look around, in every direction, there's a massive and deep body of water as far as you can see, extending 15 miles to the east, 20 miles to the west, 97 miles to the north-northwest, and a whopping 323 miles to the east-southeast. In this vast lake, what would later become the cities of Bakersfield, Stockton, Modesto, Chico, and Sacramento were more than 100 feet underwater. This overall body of water was known as Lake Corcoran, which for a time spanned an area of 19,000 square miles, a figure fairly close to the modern size of Lake Michigan. So, how did this forgotten Great Lake form, and why did it disappear? Before I answer these questions, I'm going to first remove a potential point of confusion. If you were to have looked at early 19th century maps of the Central Valley, you might correctly note a drawing of a massive body of water in the southern half of the region. This body of water, although generally often being greatly exaggerated in size in ancient maps, did indeed exist, but was not Lake Corcoran. Instead, it represents a completely separate 805 square mile lake known as Lake Tulare, which almost completely dried up in the 1890s due to water diversion by residents for agriculture and other purposes. Which, while technically a remnant of a portion of the original Lake Corcoran, you can see the vast size difference between the two. At the present, when precipitation falls in California's Great Valley, if it is not used by various plants and animals, it will eventually end up flowing west into the Sacramento Valley, going into the San Francisco Bay, and eventually ending up in the Pacific Ocean. As a result, no large lake forms. For many millions of years, prior to Lake Corcoran's formation, there continued to be one or more outlets where water would exit this basin, mainly to the south. However, something changed approximately 2 million years ago as the motion of the San Andreas Fault carried much of what is the modern coast mountains with it, moving about 35 kilometers or 21.7 miles every million years. As a result of the high motion of this tectonic plate boundary, the drainage to the south was either blocked or had its highest point rise significantly, meaning that now there was no large area pooling water could drain through. As a result, over a prolonged period of time, since more water from rain and snow flowed into the Central Valley than naturally evaporated, a lake grew larger and larger. Lake Corcoran existed between 758,000 and 665,000 years ago, although its size did fluctuate over time due to climate variations. What led to the disappearance of this lake was erosion, which occurred at what is now the modern Carquinez Strait. Eventually, a pathway was created by this erosion, causing lake water to start draining away to the west. While this started slow, it quickly snowballed in size to become a major flood involving a wall of water more than 100 feet high. It thus did not take very long for a deeper and deeper canyon to be carved away 665,000 years ago, creating the Carquinez Strait, and eventually leading to the almost complete disappearance of the overall lake. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, Helen S., for supporting my work.